Ask y'all just to be quiet for just a minute, please. I would like to say right now that you've been a swell crowd here tonight, so let's keep up the good work. And it gives me a great deal of pleasure on behalf of the PNE and C Fund to present the Beatles!
Everybody.
John.
Thanks. And good evening. How are you? Okay? All right. Good. We'd like to carry on. We'd like to carry on with a song which was on the first album that we made, first Capitol album. We hope you like the song. It's called Oh My Loving.
One, two, three, four, five.
Close your eyes and I'll kiss you. Tomorrow I'll miss you. Remember I'll always be true. And then while I'm away, I'll ride home every day. And I'll send all my lovers to you. I'll pretend that I'm to say my lips I'm missing and hope that my dreams will come true. And then while I'm away, I'll run home every day and I'll send all my lovers to you. All my lovers.
Thank you, folks. The next song we're going to do is another oldie for us. And it's called She Loves You.
She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She's thinking of, and she told me what to say, yeah. She said she loves you, and you know that can't be bad. She loves you, and you know you should be glad. She said you hurt her so, she almost lost her mind. Now she says she knows you're not the hurting kind. She said she loves you, and you know that can't be bad. She loves you, and you know you should be glad. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. With a love like that, you know you should be glad. You know it's up to you, I think it's only fair. Pride could hurt you too, apologize to her. Because she loves you, and you know that can't be bad. She loves you, and you know you should be glad. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. She loves you, yeah, yeah, yeah. With a love like that, you know you should be glad. With a love like that, you know you should be glad. With a love like that, you know you should be glad.
Thank you. I'd like to carry on now with quite a new song. I think it's on a new album over here. It's called the things we said today.
You say you will love me if I have to go. You'll be thinking of me. Somehow I will know. Someday when I'm lonely, wishing you weren't so far away, then we will remember things we said today. You say you'll be mine, girl, till the end of time. Be my one and only. Yes, you say you're mine. Someday when we're dreaming, deep in love, not a lot to say, then we will remember things we said today. I'm the girl that you had, love to hear you say that love is hard, though it may be blind. Love is here to stay, and that's enough to make you mine, girl. Be the only one. Love me all the time, girl. We'll go on and on. Someday when we're dreaming, deep in love, not a lot to say, then we will remember things we said today.
Yeah!
I'm just so lucky now, not to hear you say that love is love. So we may be blind, love is here to stay, and that's enough to make you mine, girl. Be the only one. Love me all the time, girl. We'll go on and on.
Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. We'd like to...
I hate to... look, it, we've got to back some of the people up. There's been two kids crushed already. They'll have to cancel the show. Hold it. Down. Everybody down. Or no show. The Beatles want to perform for you, but they can't do it. If you don't sit down now, let's sit down. They want to perform for you. Come on.
We'd like to ask you if you'd help us with this next song. Hello. We'd like to ask you if you'll join in. Will you join in with this next one? Will you? Okay. All right, listen, it's dead easy. All you got to do is clap your hands or stamp your feet, something like that, or sing. Do anything you like. The song's called Can't Buy Me Love. Can't buy me love. If it makes you feel alright, 'cause I don't get too much for money. Money can buy me love. I give you all I've got to give. If you say love me too, I may not have a lot to give. What I got, I'll give to you. 'Cause I don't get too much for money. Money can buy me love. Buy me love. Everybody tell me so. Money just can't buy, 'cause I don't care too much for money. Money can buy me love. Can't buy me love. Everybody tell me so. Just can't buy, 'cause I don't get too much for money. Money can buy me love. Buy me love. Love. Can't buy me love.
Thank you, folks. Before we do the next song, we've got to hang on a minute while George changes the guitar. And the song we're going to do next is a slow song from the film we just made, Hard Day's Night. And it's from the new album we've just made. And it's called If I Fell.
If I fell in love with you, would you promise to be true and help me understand? 'Cause I've been in love before, and I found that love was more than just holding hands. If I gave my heart to you, I must be sure from the very start that you would love me more than her. I trust in you. Oh, please don't run and hide. I love you too. Oh, please don't hurt my pride like her. 'Cause I couldn't stand the pain, and I would be sad if our new love was in vain. You say that I if I fell in love with you.
Thank you very much indeed, folks. Thank you. We'd like now to do something. Do something. We'd like to do something that we don't often get much of a chance to do. We'd like to feature somebody who doesn't sing very often, but he's going to sing now. Yes. Singing a song called Boy Swingo.
Latest record. It's the title song from the film called A Hot Day's Night.
Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. The Beatles have come a long way with us, with me, to do this show, and we'll have to cut it short unless you move back, because they're very worried about the situation at the front. Back. Back. Back.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. You know I work all day to get your money to buy a thing, and it's worth it just to hear you say you're gonna give me everything. Oh, why on earth should I moan? 'Cause when I get you alone, you know I feel okay. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, feeling you holding me tight, tight, yeah. It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. Cause when I get you alone, you know I feel okay. When I'm home, everything seems to be right.
you just. It's been a hard day's night. I shall be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. You know I feel alright. You know I feel alright.
Thank you very much, everybody. We'd like to thank you now for coming along tonight and being a marvelous audience. Thank you very much. We'd like to sing a song which was on the last album we made. This is an old Little Richard song and it's called Long Tall Sally.
I'm gonna tell Aunt Mary about Uncle John. He said he had the missing body, got a letter for him, baby. Yeah, now baby. About it, it's heavy. It's all Mary coming and it's up again. They got you, baby. Yeah, now, baby. Woo, baby. Jump on the everything that Uncle John needed, baby. Yeah, now, baby. Woo, baby. Jump on the
lesson in mass hysteria, you should be out here tonight to watch the Beatles on stage and to listen to it all.
You're
to admit, I like this full bow they do when they finish a number. But, boy, it's kind of noisy out there, isn't it? No doubt we'll be hearing shortly with another report from ringside from Jack Webster. I kind of wish they turned the lights on here at the stadium. All we can see, actually, is the stage, because if there's any action going on elsewhere, we can't see it.
Jack, when those lights go on, you know, the flash bulbs, right at the center stage, just down below the pit there, there's girls are literally standing up, just waving their arms and throwing papers. If that barricade wasn't there, those boys are in trouble, really. Look at them.
I'm doing you. Bruce, spell us off with a little music, and we'll check back in a few minutes, okay? Yes, you're right, Rennie. There is some police trouble. There is indeed around the stand, and they're having, yes, they're having a forcibly. In fact, it looks like somewhat of a. It looks like they are. Maybe the girl passed out. You know how these teenage girls are when this is going on. Right. If they would turn the lights on out here, we'd have a chance to see a lot more.
Better, yeah.
But folks can hear it. Sound of the Beatles with the yah-yah-yah going on. Right. Pat it down a little,
Jack,
for a minute.
You're not aware of what was taking place. Jack Webster was saying that they've been breaking down barricades down there, and the police are pushing, and the crowds are pushing. This is why this little girl got hurt. It was the pressure of both the police and the crowd pushing up against this little girl.
I'd be curious to know, too, why at certain times, certain sections of the stadium are lit up, as indeed ours was just a minute or so back.
I think they've got spotter lights around, but I think it's ridiculous that they don't turn all the lights on. I mean,
I think this would do a wave of all the rowdyism.
I think so. Plus the fact, how do we know there may be 50, 60 children right now just laying there and nobody notices them? I think this is ridiculous. Somebody had a bad idea of turning the lights on.
Lights should be on for sure. Just a reminder that this hour of On the Town tonight, a noisy hour it is from Empire Stadium, where the Beatles are in the background on stage. And it's presented by Kitts Cameras. Nice Norm Babb with his two good stores, his fine staff, and about the best merchandise in town. And by the way, I noticed that a lot of the little kids in here have those little portable tape machines, and I know that these are sold, too, by Kitts Cameras. It'd be a nice souvenir for the youngsters, though, and so many of them are taking pictures. So, Norm, you're on the right vehicle tonight, believe me. I wouldn't be surprised if the old devil was down there in the audience himself tonight.
I noticed him. He had a little beanie made out of a pizza. In case he gets stuck, he'll eat his hat.
Let's take the mic outside the window again for just a second or two and hear just a little more of the Beatles on stage at Empire Stadium. And 20,000 cheering, mostly kids. Do you recognize much of this music that's going on tonight?
No, the beat. That's all I can get, Jack. I've tried at home. I can get the words. Right now, I can't. And I truthfully can't see paying this kind of money to hear this. I might as well go and buy a single.
You're just getting to be a knocker in
your
own
way. You're right.
You know, our engineer Bob Bolt was telling me about the wattage of the public address system out here that is carrying the sound from the stage to all the people in the stadium. How many watts?
Almost 300 watts of amplifying power.
And plus their own amplifiers on stage.
Yes, it's a wild night at Empire Stadium. And you know what? It's kind of fun watching. I just hope that there's no trouble.
Okay, a little bit of a break out there. I wonder if we can go down to the field for Webster. I wonder if he's got a report at this time.
Just wait a minute, Jack.
Can we see what we can do? Oh, there's the light. All the lights are on the stadium. Now, that's as it should be. Good.
Okay. Take it away, Barry McMasters.
Barry, you got it.
All the lights have been put on in the stadium now, and you can see the kids piled up against the crush barrier. A number of youngsters have been arrested, actually. There are at least 16 or 18 in the first aid room now, and two or three arrested. One of the Sun reporters was telling me a minute ago that a couple of police officers narrowly escaped injury when the door at the quarterback top at the northwest corner was pushed over. And from where I am now, I can see a good dozen policemen holding this broken door in place to try and keep the crowds out. There are four more policemen. I don't know if they're arresting somebody. Oh, no, they're just carrying somebody away. Anyway, the crowd have been told if they don't behave themselves, the concert will be cancelled. And that's where it stands at this very moment. Anything else new?
I don't know. I've carried four little kids out. They shouldn't be out in 10 years old, 11 years old. It is a damn disgrace.
Absolute damn disgrace. That's Jack Wasserman of the Sun, whom I saw carrying away one of the youngsters here. I mean, whoever lets kids of 8, 9, 10, 11 get...
You know, they're all sobbing, they're bruised, and they're battered, and they're my knee, my side, I want to see the Beatles.
In the first aid room yet, they're still sobbing. Well, everything's under control at the moment. There goes another casualty. Oh, five.
About 5 or 6.
5 or 6? No, she's 8 or 9. 8 or 9.
Are you ready to run?
No. I think everything's under control, badly.
I doubt it. I don't think you got 5 seconds from the time they leave that stage till the time that all those hurdles are down and that there are 16 people dead.
No. Jack's putting on far too much. I think there might be a little bit of an emergency. I hope he's wrong. The Beatles' car is parked at the back of the stage here. The pressing is just in the front 25 rows of the 7,000 seats on the ground of the stadium. The stadium lights have been put on again.
One of the managers that are coining the millions out of this. I told them it's a police matter. I told them. This has been the most poorly organized advance gouge in the history of Vancouver.
Gouge is the word, I'll tell you. Well, Wasserman is a guy who knows whereof he speaks, I'll tell you that. And he does not like the situation here at the moment. The lights are still on, which indicates the authorities are not at all happy with the situation. So we'll stand by. We'll stay on the air at the moment while the lights are on to see if the crowd calms down. We'll go up towards the crush barrier again, where the children seem to be standing on each other's shoulders. Now what's happening? Okay, everything's under control at the moment. More casualties, however, are being carried out. This girl seems to be quite unconscious.
They're reaching back into the crowd now because there's people under the mass of people.
There must be. They're passing some of these casualties through the crowd of teenagers. Police have now used 2x4s to hold back the crash barrier. Okay, we'll contact you if there's any more outbreaks here at the stadium. The lights are on just now. All is quiet, comparatively, for the moment. Jack, let's do this. Something new from the control room.
Have we got it? Right. Something I feel very certain about, as we've just noticed from our vantage point up here in the press booth at Empire Stadium, is that the black limousine just rolled up alongside of stage, and I would venture a guess that when the Beatles come off that stage, they're not going to any dressing room. They'll be into that limousine and right out of the stadium just as quick as can be, and I think it's a good idea.
Tremendous. But, Jack, you notice this is the sad part. They're carrying kids off off the field. They're
some of these girls get a little emotional, you know. They get carried away. I've never seen this before. I'm a part of the Sinatra era and Presley, but I never saw this actually happen before in my life.
Well, and you notice, if everybody was to sit down in that center field, they could see. But no, they always seem to try and get higher, and they see nothing. This I can't understand. Maybe I'm an old fogey, but I just can't see their thinking.
One thing I think you'll agree is that those that are seated in the upper stands here are perfectly well-behaved.
Oh, yes.
And there's certainly no drinking or anything like that going on out here tonight that I've seen.
That's correct, Jack. I've got to admit, there's none of that.
This reminds me, I'm thirsty.
Is that right? Pass the mixer.
Right.
Now, this song that they're doing is from their latest picture.
It's a hard day's night.
Yeah, you listen to this.
I'll put the mic out the window. Another girl being carried out. I notice that.
I don't think most of it may be emotional, but I think what is happening. They're getting pushed up to the front of that barrier, and they're just losing their wind. It's just like a football player getting tackled below the belt, and I think this is what's happening. You notice the inhalator squad and the fire department is going out there now. I think they're going to give artificial respiration.
Thank you very much indeed, folks. Thank you. We'd like to do something. We'd like to do something we don't often get much of a chance to do. We'd like to
they're not exactly the world's best MCs, but the kids love it.
Oh, yes, but did you notice how their humor was during the press conference? They were fast.
They have a great sense of humor, and this is... Wow! Kidding, and there was another girl being carried out up front. Say, I didn't. Well, that's about the fifth or sixth girl that I've seen being carried out. One boy has broken away, is trying to climb up on the seat. You notice right in front down here?
Yeah.
My, there's a lot going on in here this evening.
Chairs going and everything. It could get very unruly, Jack.
Somebody's trying to throw chairs over the barrier out there.
I think this is the biggest talk back to Webster that's happening around that stage right now. Look at that. Look at the chairs being thrown out.
Webster will probably pick it up down below very shortly. Okay, well, we kind of catch our breath and keep our eyes peeled out here for any further trouble at Beatles Stadium this evening.
Barry McMaster here for Jack Webster right at the moment. The tension is mounting, the excitement is mounting. Also mounting is the speed and the number of casualties in the crowd being lifted over these four barricades and taken for first aid treatment. Many girls are shaking, purely hysterical, crying, sobbing. Still, many young children who should never have been here in the first place. The police pressure against the barricades is continuing. Despite the 2x4s, they are still insufficient against the growing crowd. The crowd has just been told that if they don't settle down, the show will be called off, and that will be it. Jack Webster, do you have any
questions? I just noticed that they've called reinforcements from the fire department now. There's at least two fire department crews here to help man the barricade, because a good number of the police are being held in reserve to protect the Beatles' car, which is behind the North End of the stage. Now, another batch of men are being put over to help hold back the crowds right now. This guy, as you said, by stopped the show, and he said we're getting concerned about the crushing at the front, and unless the crowds move back, we will cut the show short. It had some effect for a matter of 90 seconds. And now they're back here again. 60 seconds, 90 seconds. Well, the show's got about, I would say, the Beatles have got 4 or 5 minutes to go. And then we're inclined to see some scenes of mass hysteria, Barry. And we'll do bulletins if anything breaks out.
Right. Jack Webster, Barry McMaster, reporting from near the stage.
We're back up in our broadcast booth, and from here we can see an enormous amount of girls being carried out. The firemen are rushing out, the St. John ambulance, anybody that can carry these girls off the field. And I notice some of them are coming back to life, as you could say, and walking out, but under the assistance of the St. John ambulance. St. John ambulance tonight are working very hard and very fast. I don't know where they're taking them all, but In 10 minutes, if this goes on, the whole stadium will be carried out.
You know, I don't think that some of these teenage girls are emotionally equipped to handle this. You know, they've idolized these fellas for so long now. Gee, here they are, really in the in effect, and they just can't cope with it. Listen to this.
It's mass hypnosis, Jack. As soon as they do something, the Beatles, anything, you notice how the reaction is?
In case you don't know, they're doing a thing called Long Call Sally, and I learned during the press interview tonight that the Beatles are quite fond of a mad fellow named Little Richard, who for a while turned to a rock and roll religion, and now I believe is back firmly as an entertainer, but he had retired for some years. And when I gave the guy, one of the Beatles, I think it was John, rather a weird look for his musical taste of liking Little Richard, he kind of put me down with his thumb, but that's the way it is.
Jack, one thing I noticed, and I'm very proud of this, that during the whole press conference, Jack Cullen was throwing all the questions and CKNW was mentioned entirely. You notice that?
Maybe we're lucky tonight. But they, I noticed there's now two limousines, and I still feel that the Beatles and the Indians are running, the lights are on. I feel that when the Beatles leave that stage, they'll not be going to the dressing room. They will be whisked out of here, and as we gathered from our press conference with them earlier tonight, they'll be going right back to the airport and out of town as quick as they can, and apparently not to Seattle. I believe they said to California, did they not?
Right, yeah, they're going right back to California. But the funny bit about all these cars pulling in, wouldn't it be a funny thing if the St. John Ambulance Boys got in and drove off?
By the way, folks, this riot tonight is presented, we drummed it up especially for Kit's camera.
That's Nolan
Brown, Kit's cameras. He wanted to get some exciting pictures. And believe me, he's getting it. We're glad you all came.
That's right. And you notice a lot of the people are moving now. I think they're trying to avoid the crowd. They know this is the wrap-up. But they're still passing out, and they're being carried out right now.
But the only rowdyism you will see is not from those in the bleachers in the stands.
Yeah.
It's those that are actually seated on the grass out there. Yeah, on the field.
I'm dying to see what happens when they finally leave. The whole thing's just going to break up.
Is it? Can they get off the stage? I see on the track here, there's a couple of fellows trying to break the 440 mark.
Yeah, they're coming around. I don't know. You notice they ran around the track instead of across the grass. They must be football players.
And there's still a tremendous
they're leaving the
outside.
Stage, Jack.
Are they leaving now? They're attempting to leave. That may be a one-time bout. They're not walking off. They're running off.
They're running
behind the stage. And I believe, from what we can see, they're behind the stage right now.
No, they're getting into the car.
Are they getting into the car?
Motorcycle
escort already. Boy, that's what I call quick.
FM.
To the FM, okay. Go.
You never saw such a fast thing in your life. The Beatles finished their number, ran straight across the grass to where everybody else in their party was already in the police escort with 15 motorcycles and 4 Cadillacs, and very quick and slick exit indeed, which has avoided any trouble. Somebody at least deserves congratulations. There never was a better escape, even during the war, than that particular anticlimax. They finished their last number, they dropped their instruments, they ran down the back stairs, the cars were here with their engines running, they went straight into the cars and off. And you know, it's quite a thankful feeling of relief. Because at one stage there, it looked as if they were going to overwhelm the stage. And now that the Beatles have departed, and everybody knows they've departed, all that remains now is for the first aid to must be close on now, by now, 50 or 60 casualties. So the worst fears didn't come to pass at all because of the incredible slip-out by the four Beatles, who ran full speed to the waiting Cadillac with everyone else sitting there looking grim and tense and left. Now the 16,000 youngsters will make their happy way home, having seen and admired their heroes, the Beatles. Hey, Barry boy?
I agree, Jack. I once heard that you have 3 seconds to surprise anybody and make a getaway. I don't think it could have been more than
that. The Beatles could be bank robbers the way they slipped that one on. That was a beautiful exit. They're still carrying bodies out. We don't anticipate any more trouble at all, though. Maybe it's just beginning to break through to the crowd now that the Beatles have gone. Boy, that was a quick ending. No hostility, it seems, they're accepting the fact the Beatles have gone. And Barry McMaster, a few jelly beans came towards one of the policemen there, and Barry McMaster and Jack Webster will also soon be gone. If my daughter's listening to a transistor, I'll meet you in the car park, Jenny.
Right.
And that was about the slickest. That was about the slickest getaway scene. It broke every etiquette of show business. I think they took one quick curt bow
and they
bolted off that stage. Not a second. I mean, the fans were stunned, I'm sure. And before you knew it, they were into the limousine and drove right out. So we had it pitched pretty well.
Oh, right.
But it's clever. It had to be that way. Because if they'd lingered in dressing rooms or even stayed in the grounds for any more than 5 minutes, trouble would have ensued, I'm quite sure.
I noticed that a lot of the fans, as soon as they saw they were leaving, rushed out of the stadium, over to the right here, that is, and onto Hastings Street so they could at least wave them out of town.
Right.
And that verifies, too, the fact that they are at the Hollywood Bowl tomorrow in Hollywood. They'll be flying out immediately, and I imagine they'll get a couple of winks of sleep on the plane on the way down.
Right, and I hope all the girls who were carried off are in better shape right now, and we've always said that our police department was a good police department. They proved it tonight, Jack. That's it from Empire Stadium.
It's been a blow-by-blow fight, and it was described by four of us.
Right.
And we don't know quite what we've learned here tonight, except that music is here to stay, and not too much did we hear around here tonight.
Yeah, and Bruce will put in music till after news. That'll give us a chance to get down onto the P&E grounds. We'll pick you up from there, courtesy of Kit's camera, right up till 10 o'clock.
Okay.